Hi, I'm Pat Clark from Lifting Gear Hire Corporation, and today we're discussing troubleshooting ideas regarding our Minifor electric cable hoist. As mentioned in the Minifor demonstration video, it's crucial to have a proper power source. Firmly affixed on the pendant is a reference card that shows the proper gauge and length extension cord required to power this unit. Inside of here is an electromagnetic brake. If you do experience a loud humming or buzzing sound, it could be due that the brake is actually jammed. It could also be due to you have an inferior power source or you've experienced a drop in voltage. If the motor stops, it could be for several reasons. Because this hoist is electric, it does have a duty cycle, specifically 25%, meaning that out of every hour, you can count on being able to utilize the hoist about every 15 minutes or so. Also, you want to check the pendant. Ensure that the emergency stop is not engaged. The hoist also comes with upper and lower limit switches. Ensure that those are not engaged or they might be malfunctioning. In addition, inside the motor, there might be some defective or worn contacts. And lastly, because of inferior power sources, you might have blown a fuse or tripped a breaker. If the motor only goes in one direction, it could be attributed to engaging one of the limit switches. In this example, you have engaged the lower limit switch simply because the hoist was hung in an area not very visible. Just run the hoist in the opposite direction to alleviate that issue. Secondly, you could also have worn or malfunctioning contacts or a control box. If your cable is binding, it could be due to several reasons. Every day before each use, you want to thoroughly inspect the entire length of the cable. You want to look for any frayed wires, bird caging, or even kinks. Depending on the length of the rental, this is not really that uncommon. However, if you do have damage, it can be further exacerbated by passing through the housing of the hoist. It can also be caused by the load line being wrapped around the slack line, or when hoisting or lowering, the wire rope could be caught up on something. Either way, if there's damage, the right thing to do is to replace it immediately. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting video on the Minifors. We hope that you found it helpful. In our rental fleet, we offer 660 and 1100 pound capacities. For more questions about this product and other products we rent, give us a call. As a reminder, the contents of this video were for informational purposes only. Please consult the manufacturer's guidelines and use and care instructions before beginning.